Yes!
One thing that I can confirm is that every Destiny player has a favorite weapon or two. And when it comes to legendary weapons, it's likely that you have a favorite perk or two as well. Now, depending on the weapon or archetype, there are certain perks that I've always felt are mandatory. And no matter how old I get, the sight of explosions will always have that wow factor. So perks such as Firefly and Dragonfly will always be a few of my many favorites. But for those of y'all that never played Destiny 1, out of the two aforementioned perks, you're mostly familiar with Dragonfly, as Firefly didn't make its Destiny 2 debut until the Forsaken expansion, as one of the trait perks belonging to the exotic hand cannon Ace of Spades. And back then, it probably struck you as odd that a kinetic weapon had the capability of dealing elemental damage, since Dragonfly has always been a perk that can only roll on energy weapons. If you felt that this was strange, it makes me wonder how you would react if I told you that Firefly was a very common and popular legendary trait perk in Destiny 1. This means that there was a plethora of kinetic weapons that could deal elemental damage in Destiny 1. But during Season of the Splicer, the Vault of Glass raid returned from Destiny 1, and all of its respective weapons, for the exception of the shotgun obviously, can all roll Firefly, and two of these weapons are kinetic. The topic of Dragonfly versus Firefly came about because I personally didn't expect for Firefly to ever return in Destiny 2. So in this video, I want to discuss the differences between Firefly and Dragonfly, and my thoughts on Firefly returning to Destiny 2. So, all of that out the way, let's go ahead and get it in. Okay, so Firefly. We established that this perk made its Destiny 2 debut as one of the perks belonging to the Ace of Spades. This was during the Forsaken era, Destiny 2's fourth season back in 2018. As of presently, we're in the 14th season, an entire 3 years later, and this is how long it took for Firefly to become a perk available on legendary weapons in Destiny 2. But at this very moment, aside from the Ace of Spades, Firefly can roll on the following weapons: Fatebringer, Vision of Confluence, Praetor's Revenge, and Corrective Measure. Originally, I wasn't sure why Bungie made the decision to make it Firefly exclusively available on the Vault of Glass weapons, but then I thought about something. Reintroducing a Destiny 1 perk and only making it available on weapons that are also from Destiny 1 has a lot of logic, because I personally see this as Bungie testing the waters with Firefly as a perk in Destiny 2, so who's to say that it won't become available as a perk on non-Vault of Glass legendary weapons in the future? Honestly, nobody can confirm or deny this, because only time will tell. Firefly was so beloved because it made short work of red health bar trash mobs. All it would take is for one enemy to die from a headshot, and everything else around it would meet a collateral damage death from a solar damage explosion. This perk has always been odd because if featured on kinetic and solar damage weapons, the explosion always dealt solar damage, but the explosion would have the visual effect of solar damage, even if the weapon itself was arc or void. This means that surrounded enemies killed by the Firefly explosion would die as if they were defeated by arc or void damage. Again, despite the fact that the Firefly explosion itself had the visual effect of solar damage. I didn't think much of this in Destiny 1, but looking back on it, that was pretty odd. Firefly has always been a visually appealing perk because, like I said earlier, seeing things explode is a sight that rarely ever gets boring. Fatebringer and the original vendor role of Dead Orbit's Hung Jury SR4 were two of the most beloved legendary weapons from Destiny 1, because both of these weapons were incredibly viable in PvE activities, had amazing stats, and also had Firefly as one of their perks. So it's not a surprise that both of these weapons ended up returning to Destiny 2. I said this plenty of times in the past, but Destiny 1's weapon loadout system was primary, special, and heavy, which is similar but not identical to Destiny 2's kinetic, special, and heavy approach. In D1, elemental and kinetic damage weapons shared the primary slot, and since kinetic weapons struggle with dealing with elemental shields, elemental damage weapons always saw more use in PvE. Now, going into year 2 of Destiny 1, elemental damage primary weapons were all sunset, but the only weapon that could deal elemental damage was the exotic auto rifle, Zalo Supercell. With legendary elemental damage weapons going into retirement, the value of Firefly skyrocketed because this perk provided the only means for kinetic damage weapons to deal elemental damage. It wasn't much, but it was something. Going into Destiny 2, Firefly was nowhere to be seen. Instead, it was replaced by the perk known as Dragonfly. Dragonfly functions the same as Firefly, but it's special because it can inflict arc, void, and solar damage. Granted, Firefly could do the same thing, but Dragonfly actually displays the correct elemental explosion animations, so the days of being restricted to a solar damage visualization are over. And this may be incredibly obvious, but Dragonfly's damage type always relies on the element of the weapon itself. So as of right now, we've established that both of these perks are very similar and fulfill the same role, but which perk is the better of the two? If I'm being 100% honest, I was really not looking forward to comparing the damage of these perks, mostly due to the fact that since they're more tailored to PvE, you would think that testing the damage of PvE would be the way to go. But it wasn't, and I found that out the hard way. Enemies in PvE move around too much, as expected, and I could never find consistent damage numbers, so I decided to test things in PvP instead. The goal was to simply find out which perk dealt the most damage, so me and a few friends loaded into a private match. I found out that Firefly dealt 81 explosion damage, while Dragonfly dealt 65, but Dragonfly received a damage increase to 96 from Dragonfly spec. as expected. I was curious to see if Firefly would receive a damage bonus from Dragonfly spec, and it turns out that it doesn't. I was aware that this wouldn't work, but I still wanted to test it anyways. Now, there's a couple of tidbits of information to take from this. The most obvious one is that Dragonfly is undoubtedly an inferior perk in comparison to Firefly, but not by the damage alone. Firefly has the added benefit of increasing weapon reload speed as well, so without Dragonfly spec, there's absolutely no competition between Firefly and Dragonfly. Also, another thing I want to note is that Firefly and the solar damage version of Dragonfly look identical. Sure, there's a small blast radius buff from Dragonfly spec, but if you were to see a Dragonfly explosion and a Firefly explosion side by side, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference. And after I figure all this out, I instantly realized that one of my favorite and most used exotic weapons got the short end of the stick. I'm referring to the Polaris Lance. If you've unlocked the catalyst for the Polaris Lance, you would know that it gains access to Dragonfly. Polaris Lance is a year one exotic weapon, and if you've been around since year one, it's no secret that a lot of things have changed since then. And in this current state, I would say the Polaris Lance is lacking in potential for some of the most stupid reasons. I'll explain. Polaris Lance became a part of this test because I assumed that his Dragonfly perk would deal more damage because it's exotic. This may sound like a ridiculous assumption, but hear me out. I want to use the Huckleberry's reference because the Huckleberry's Rampage perk deals more damage than it would if it was on a legendary weapon. 3 stacks of Rampage on the Huckleberry equates to a damage increase of 66%, but as a perk feature on legendary weapons, Rampage times 3 grants a damage bonus of 33%. This is literally half the damage of what Huckleberry's Rampage perk is capable of. However, there was a point in time where the 66% damage bonus of Rampage times 3 was present on legendary weapons as well, but Rampage eventually received a nerf that cut his damage in half. But Huckleberry was completely unaffected by this and retained the pre-nerf damage bonus. So I assumed that there was some likelihood a Polaris Lance would receive a similar benefit for his Dragonfly perk. Turns out that it doesn't. The explosion damage of Polaris Lance's Dragonfly in PvP was 65, as it would be for a legendary weapon. And that sucks, because no matter which way you slice the cake, Polaris Lance's Dragonfly will always have less potential than it would if it were a perk belonging to a legendary weapon, because legendary weapons can simply equip a Dragonfly spec mod for increased damage. Exotic weapons can't equip mods, so yeah, you get it. To mitigate this, Bungie could easily update the Catalyst perk of Polaris Lance to Firefly. Since Dragonfly is weaker than Firefly, Polaris Lance is effectively an exotic weapon with a lackluster catalyst, and it's more than deserving of having its catalyst perk changed to Firefly. This would not only make this weapon more powerful, but it will also increase its reload speed after killing enemies with headshots. Now, I'm aware that this can be a bit counterintuitive because Polaris Lance's exotic perk refunds rounds to the magazine if they dealt precision damage, but let's be real. Nobody is able to hit crits 100% of the time, and it's impossible to prevent the inevitable point in time where you'll have to reload your weapon. But if Dragonfly absolutely has to stay, why not give it the same benefits of Dragonfly spec? Or just remove Dragonfly spec from the game and buff Dragonfly since it's already inferior to Firefly as it is. This would give Polaris Lance a lot more potential, and it will also make Dragonfly a significantly better perk. Oh, and did you know that if you use a kinetic weapon with Firefly, while using the exotic Warlock chest armor Chromatic Fire, you'll actually spawn 2 explosions? The Ace of Spades or Chromatic Fire both came out back at Forsaken, so that's when I originally found this out. But it's awesome to know that this will also work with other kinetic weapons that can roll Firefly as well. The first explosion will always be solar, but the second explosion for Chromatic Fire will always match the element of whatever light subclass you're using. I specifically said light subclass because it turns out that this exotic has no compatibility with stasis, and I assume that this will also apply to the other darkness subclasses we'll get later. I hope that Bungie looks into this one day, because a stasis explosion spawn from headshots will be so dope. Now, do I think that Firefly and Dragonfly should coexist? This question is a bit complex to answer because my answer would be both yes and no. Okay, so due to the fact that Dragonfly can deal solar arc or void damage and receives the damage explosion proximity increase via the Dragonfly spec mod, if you weren't already aware of the damage differences, you might think that Firefly would be an inferior perk, since Firefly can only deal solar damage. Like I said before, Dragonfly was originally meant to replace Firefly and is only present on energy weapons, but Firefly can roll on kinetic and energy weapons too, and I don't really see the point of that. It would have made a lot more sense to introduce Firefly as a kinetic damage exclusive perk to further differentiate itself from Dragonfly, and if things were done this way, Firefly and Dragonfly would have been the perfect antitheses of one another. If Bungie took the route of removing Dragonfly spec from the game and giving its benefits to Dragonfly like I suggested earlier, both perks would be amazing options and we would no longer be stuck with a very solid perk and its less powerful multi-elemental version. Or Bungie could simply remove solar damage as one of the options for Dragonfly, since solar damage Dragonfly and Firefly are pretty much the same. You know, I just don't see the point of that either. So yeah, if I were to base my opinions on how things currently are, I don't think that Firefly and Dragonfly should coexist. If things were changed around a bit to give these perks more differences, then I wouldn't have a problem with both of them being in the same game. I just feel that it was pointless to invest so much into creating a successor to the Firefly perk, except making it worse, only to bring Firefly back. Bungie is known for making some stupid decisions, but this is probably one of the best examples of such. If you would have asked me if I would like to see Firefly return in Destiny 2 a couple years back, the answer would have been no, and I'm saying this with the realization of how much I loved that perk back in Destiny 1. Back then, I was in a mind state of Dragonfly existing as a replacement to Firefly, and the thought of both of these perks in the same game was completely superfluous, despite the fact that Dragonfly was very subpar in the earliest days of Destiny 2, and was originally perceived as an unworthy successor to the Firefly perk. Dragonfly's existence made a lot more sense logically. Dragonfly was, and to this day, is a perk that can only roll on elemental damage weapons, and is perfectly justified for a perk with elemental damage attributes to only be available as a perk option for elemental damage weapons. Accompanying that, the word Firefly implies a fiery connotation, denoting that this perk is only capable of dealing solar damage. But there is no elemental connotation attributed to the word Dragonfly, and Bungie opted for a different name because Dragonfly can deal not only solar damage, but arc and void damage as well. And I understood all of this back in year 1 of Destiny 2. Remember when I said that Firefly in Destiny 1 would always exhibit the visual effect of a solar damage explosion, even if the weapon that it belonged to dealt arc or void damage? I guess this had a lot to do with how the perk was coded, and Bungie felt that it was a lot easier to just leave it this way. I'm pretty sure that changing the animation of the explosion to match the element of its respective weapon would have caused a ton of problems in the game's netcode. It was probably easier to change things in Destiny 2 since D2 was an entirely new game, and when you think about all of this, it's pretty safe to say that this is pretty much how Dragonfly came into existence. Firefly made his Destiny 2 debut as one of the perks for the exotic hand cannon Ace of Spades, and when I found this out, I felt that it was appropriate that the only kinetic weapon in the game at the time that could deal elemental damage was an exotic weapon, and such was only possible via a perk, as Ace of Spades can't deal elemental damage on its own. And the Ace of Spades version of Firefly had the added benefit of increasing reload speed, so it was pretty much a combination of Firefly and Outlaw, or Feeding Frenzy, combined into one perk. So I said that Firefly could roll on kinetic and elemental damage weapons in Destiny 1, and this is also the case in Destiny 2. For instance, Fatebringer and Vision of Confluence both have access to this perk, but in Destiny 2, Fatebringer is kinetic and Vision of Confluence is solar. When Firefly became available as a perk on legendary weapons in Destiny 2's 14th season, it retained the increased reload speed that was present on Ace of Spades version of Firefly. This was good to know because I was always worried that it wouldn't be possible to introduce the original Fatebringer into Destiny 2. I'll explain what I mean. Okay, so the D1 version of Fatebringer dealt arc damage, and since raid weapons had static rolls, Fatebringer always had Firefly, Explosive Rounds, and Outlaw. Now, if this is your first time seeing this, it may strike you as odd that the Explosive Rounds perk is present in the middle perk column. In Destiny 1, Explosive Rounds was treated as a magazine perk, no differently than the high caliber rounds of Snapshot Sights. But in Destiny 2, Snapshot Sights and Explosive Rounds were reallocated to the trait perk slot, meaning that it wouldn't be possible for a weapon in Destiny 2 to roll Outlaw, Firefly, and Explosive Rounds simultaneously. If the D2 version of Firefly lacked the benefit of a reload speed bonus, the Destiny 2 version of Fatebringer would have been perceived as inferior to its D1 version, and that would have made a lot of people mad because Fatebringer is one of the most coveted and popular legendary weapons in the entire Destiny franchise. It's already bad enough that the Vault of Glass Raid Exotic Vest Mythic class in Destiny 2 is a shadow of its D1 version. So if the franchise's very first Raid Exotic and the most beloved Raid Hand Cannon were both terrible in Destiny 2, the Destiny community would have lost its collective mind. It's sad to know that the Vest Mythic class performs so much worse than its D1 version, but I suppose it is consoling to know that Bungie found a way to give us something as close to the D1 Fatebringer as possible. But yeah, that does it for this one, everybody. When the Ace of Spades came out back at Forsaken, I was happy to know that it had Firefly. Now that Firefly is back as a legendary perk, that's even better news, but the best news would be a buff to Dragonfly. Hopefully this occurs in the near future, because since Vanilla Destiny 2, there have been millions of complaints about this perk and how inferior it is in comparison to Firefly. Now it's even more evident because both perks are in the same game, so let's keep our fingers crossed that it actually happens. Anyways, if you made it to the end of this video and enjoyed what you watched, do me a favor and thumb rest of that like button until it turns blue. And if you're new to my neck of the woods, go ahead and subscribe to the channel and click that bell icon so you don't ever miss a video of the most elite gaming content. But with that being stated, 1LHD is over and out. Y'all take it easy. Can you think, you and me, don't you wanna feel something? Oh, I miss loving you.
little something from Miss Angelou. Take the good and hold it near to you, and let go of all the burdens you